Hello, I'm Yoshiko Iwamoto Wada. I'm a textile artist, curator, also president of the World Shibori Network. But I happen to be bringing a group of fantastic Afro-American quilts to the Festival of Quilts in 2007 this time. These are, some of them anonymous, many of them are living artists, quilters, and there's one in particular who is a star of this exhibition, Rosie Lee Tompkins, who just passed away last year. And this one is done by Arbie Williams. She creates quite a lot of these wonderful Britches quilts. She uses used castaway pans and other scraps and put them together in such a spontaneous, bold manner. She can put together quilts, Arbie said, two or three in a day. And she can finish a quilt in 3 days completely. This is Arbie Williams' Britches quilt. She works, she has such fun with using castaway pants. Well, in America we say pants, but here you say trousers, a pair of trousers. She actually kind of fillet the trousers and flat. And then you don't really see the shape of the trousers, more like abstract shape in the middle. And this one is very typically American in that it has this kind of pop daisy design, and she didn't have to do too much piecing, but again, if you step back and look at it, it's almost like a pop art. This is the largest quilt in this exhibition, and this is called Three Sixes by Rosie Lee Tompkins. And Rosie Lee Tompkins is a pseudonym used by a lady artist whose name is Effie Mae Howard. And she had kept her anonymity until she passed away last December. So we could not show this until this year because she embroidered her name and some of the verses or scriptures, numbers or dates of her family member's birthday. And it's a very personal expression in terms of her religious beliefs and her personal relationship with family members. And it's almost like a journal for her. And some of her quilts, she worked on it for decades because she did not plan to finish a project per se, like many quilters do. This is something she did personally in a way to deal with her fear, her concerns, her creative expressions, and she wanted to live with her quilts. She never wanted to sell her quilts if she could help it. So she would go back and sometimes embroider something that comes to her mind. And so we would never know if this quilt is completely finished or not, because she's gone now. But this is called Three Sixes, and she had made quite a few quilts in this series. And she always uses purple, yellow, orange, and that variation of these colors, because that to her relate to her family members' birthdays. This is a quilt by Mamie Jones, and it's one of my favorite quilts in the sense that it's almost like abstract expressionist painting. And a lot of really hardcore quilters are bothered by irregularity of the shape and the buckling of the pieces. But if you step back and look at it, you'll be just overwhelmed by the power and the simplicity and the boldness. And you need to see these work as an artwork, not a quilt and such. And the group of quilts that I have shown you here are really viewed as an artistic expression, artwork. And so you have to kind of not to get too much in detail about how they pieced it, what the stitches are, and that kind of beautiful artistry. Of course, I would admire that too. But I think in the end, these are so powerful in that it will speak to people who are not interested in quilts per se. The work like this could fit in any kind of architectural situation. This particular piece is done by Yvonne Wells. Actually, she was a teacher, and then she started quilting. She's very interested in a story quilt. Of course, she does other traditional strip quilts and bow tie quilts and so forth, but her strongest work is in story quilts. And this is about slavery and civil rights movement and what went on in America, North America. And it is quite direct and powerful. And in the same genre, there's another artist right next to it. This is Mary Lucas. It is like the story quilts that Yvonne Wells has done. It is a pictorial quilt, and it's titled Black Men and Flowers. And it has black men, and the rest is covered with very wonderful, simple flowers in a style of kind of art naivete. And again, if you are bothered by the craftsmanship, the fabric is buckled and so forth, but actually it sort of adds interesting texture, and the childlike, wonderful simplicity of each shape really speaks to people in a wide audience. And amazing array of scraps. So the colors and prints are put together in a very straightforward manner. And it is just fantastic. It's like Rousseau's painting. This is Laverne Bracken. And the next to it is Sherry Bird. And Laverne is the mother, Sherry Bird is a daughter. And Laverne Bracken's mother is Gladys Henry. And Sherry Bird's daughter is Barra Bird. All four women in the family, four generations of women in the family quilt. And very artistic, very productive ladies in the family. And this is Laverne's work, using, again, scraps. You can see some hospital gowns and maybe nurses' outfits, and all sorts of scrap fabrics are juxtaposed with solid colors. And she's one of the main quilters in America where she can get almost like any design, any colors put together and hold it together. In a similar way, her daughter Sherry Bird works with brilliant colors, bold shapes, and so much fun. And you would think this pink and red and some yellow, I mean, it'll be very garish. It is a little wild, but still, when you step back and you see it, and how she puts that all together, and makes almost like a jazz again, you know, improvisational aspect of Afro-American quilts. And the power that they convey is really fantastic. So the last one that I'm going to show you is, again, another Rosie Lee Tompkins quilt. And this is, again, the scrap fabric being used. Interestingly, in this one, She used a lot of white, which is unusual for her because she likes very rich texture, rich colors. But somewhat this white with bright colors work really, really well. And then again, she started stitching over like 10-year period. This one is being stitched. She worked on it for like past 10 years. And she stitched her real name, Effie Mae Howard. And there's some scriptures number, John 1:1-3:1b. And her work is very interesting. If you look up the scripture and the meaning of it, and then you kind of guess what was in her mind while she was working on that, what went through in her family situation or her mind, which is very, very interesting. And again, that yellow sort of goes right over, and she didn't care where the quilt gets a little crumpled up and it gets contorted a little. But in the end, it just makes such a powerful statement. Her work is in the Whitney Museum of American Art in New York. She's considered one of the prime American artists. They wouldn't even put quilt artist for her as a subtitle. She's the artist, which represents the Afro-American aesthetics and then powerful statement that comes with it. So this is the exhibition I entitled Sunshine and a Surprise. And the Creative Exhibitions Limited generously funded the exhibition to come to United Kingdom. It's a long way and there are a lot of logistics problems, but you were able to see these fantastic Afro-American quilts, which are rarely seen in this part of the world. And I hope you enjoyed it.